The sister of a man beaten, tortured, and murdered 3 decades ago says she will fight for the life of the killer.
Barring a successful appeal, Nebraska will execute Michael Ryan 2 weeks from tomorrow. It's capital punishment for the 1985 murder of James Tim on a cult compound outside Rulo.
Only on 7 tonight, Tim's sister explains why she believes Ryan's life should be spared. KATV News Watch 7's Christina Engdahl reports.
It's been 30 years since Miriam Tim lost her younger brother, James. His young life ended when he was murdered at a cult compound just outside Rulo, Nebraska. Miriam visited the place her brother died.
The hair on the back of my neck stood up. It was like I could feel that it was just so bad.
Cult leader Michael Ryan was convicted of first-degree murder in 1985. His victims, James Tim and 5-year-old Luke Stice. Ryan is supposed to die on March 6th.
When we talk about funding for the death penalty, when we slash mental health funding, we are making a big mistake.
Despite the graphic details surrounding her brother's death, Miriam forgives Michael Ryan, saying he's a sick man.
Really look at, you know, was mine mentally ill? He's never had an MRI scanner, you know. He acts a lot like a paranoid schizophrenic.
Ryan's then attorney made that argument all along.
I'm very sad because Mr. Ryan is a very sick person.
But Miriam says the state chooses to ignore Ryan's illness, so Miriam chooses to fight.
All the lawyers, all the fighting, life without parole, and that frees up all that money for good. How can you not fight the death penalty?
Miriam already has one victory, helping another man who tortured her brother, Timothy Haverkamp, a man named High Priest in Ryan's cult.
I wrote to the parole board, all the members, and helped him get out.
Miriam maintains a relationship with Haverkamp, inviting him to a peaceful protest on March 6th.
On the day that Michael Ryan is scheduled to be executed, Miriam, along with anti-death penalty protesters, will be miles away from the penitentiary. They'll be here in the sanctuary of the First Mennonite Church.
I want to set up an open forum for people of both sides, pro and con, to come and just kind of remember James.
Miriam says if the state hopes to bring her family closure by killing, they won't.
Because closure is when it's not in the newspaper anymore. It's not on the news anymore. And it's done.
In Lincoln, Christina Engdahl, KETV, News Watch 7.
We just spoke with a relative of Ryan's youngest victim, 5-year-old Luke Stice. Doris Simpson says Ryan, quote, tied him to a post outdoors in a blizzard in just his underwear. Now you tell me he should live, end quote. Ryan is scheduled to be executed March 6th. That's 2 weeks from tomorrow.